Alex Becker is a multi-million dollar tech entrepreneur who has had many successful businesses. He has an SEO company, an online marketplace for services called Conquer, and many successful software products. Alex achieved amazing things in the past 8 years of being an entrepreneur and shared all his experience in this amazing book. So without any further ado, let's dive right into it. If you work a normal full-time job, then congratulations, you have just given up 71% of your life so that you can sit comfortably in the latter part of your life. A full-time job is the getting rich slowly mindset that kills your quality of life. You are working 40 to 50 hours a week with a lot of stress just so you can enjoy the rest of your time with your friends and family. The thing I need you to understand is that you can get rich quickly for one and one reason only. You control everything. And I'll explain. Everything you do directly controls how much money you make. For instance, when you start working out, you are likely to suck at it, get frustrated and possibly even quit. That is the whole reason why most people consider it too hard and too risky. And that's just fucking stupid. It just has a steep learning curve and you are likely to fail at first. But if you stick with it for a year or two, like playing a video game, eventually you will get good at it. It's just a matter of time. You control your life, you can get better at anything and you are allowed to fail. Getting rich slowly requires you to spend 71% of your days at work. Regardless of your view on money, your time is the greatest sacrifice in the getting rich slowly plan. Instead of spending your time working, you should spend your time to create systems that do the work for you, aka passive income. Setting up such a machine takes a lot of time and effort, but once it is built, it generates income and it's completely separated from your time. Look at software. The ads, the billing process, and the website, and the actual software all require a significant time to create. However, once it is built, it requires very little time to maintain. The machine you have to create can take many forms. And I talked about this in the 4-hour work week. A machine could be the software I talked about, it could be a website with an automated delivery system. Just be creative and figure out how you can separate your time from your business. Therefore, the first pillar of wealth, reject getting rich slow and separate time from money. Next, I want to talk about the mindset you have to apply in order to become wealthy. The truth is, you will not succeed if you do not believe you will succeed. You have to believe you are the best. Did you know only 1% of the households are considered millionaires? So, in other words, by saying you want to become wealthy, you are accepting the challenge to be better at making money than 99% of the people. If you think differently, you're done before you even get started. You must believe and accept the fact that you are great. So how do you do this? You need to adapt an abundance mindset. Actions are controlled by mindsets and beliefs. It is impossible for you to become a millionaire without believing that money is abundant. If you're not willing to risk it all, then you simply don't want it badly enough. If you don't want it badly enough, then you will never achieve it. So the second pillar of wealth, become better than everyone else by accepting an abundance mindset. In order to achieve your goals, you have to take a certain number of actions to get there. And many times people get locked in a perfection paralysis. What this means is that you are solely focusing on the hypothetical problems. You are so focused or worried about getting things right that you never make a move. So imagine you're a car salesman. Instead of trying to sell cars, you first study your coworkers and read a ton of books on selling before you even try to sell a car, because you want your conversations and sales pitch to be perfect. In the meantime, your coworkers are doing their best to sell cars. They are adjusting their sales pitch if they notice it is not working, and they are learning from their mistakes. In short, they take action and deal with problems when they become problems. The best way to learn is to experience something yourself. There's just no way you can predict every possible problem there is. What I'm trying to say is that planning for every potential problem before you take action will not help you succeed. Unfortunately, people are taught to think in terms of what if. What if I can do that? What if I do not succeed? What if everybody makes fun of me? If you let these negative beliefs control you, you will never succeed in life. In order to reach your goals, you have to look differently at failures and making mistakes. And here's how. The biggest mistake you can make while trying to reach your goal is not doing anything at all. The best way to learn is by making mistakes. Actions will almost always lead to mistakes. But if you never take action, you will never reach your goal. Therefore, there's a very little chance of reaching success without making mistakes. This is so simple yet so important to understand. The sooner you make your first mistakes, the sooner you will hit your success. Therefore, the third pillar of wealth, forget what if and focus on what is. What you need to understand in order to become wealthy is that without other people, you will not become rich. Easy, right? Let me explain a bit further. In order for someone to be rich, other people need to exist to give you the power of being rich. So the true secret to making money is getting people to do what you want. If you're trying to get rich, you are basically trying to gain control over other people. Many people seem to forget that whenever they start a business, the first thing they have to do in order to become successful and rich is to convince someone to write them a check. The first line of every business is selling. A business's growth is determined by its sales. A business with a great product but no sales is a dead business. Alex talks in the pillars to focus solely on what gets you paid. And the only thing that can get you paid is to sell. If you're afraid of selling, then you have two options. Either hire someone to do the selling for you, or don't start a business that requires selling. You can be the biggest failure in the entire world and your business can suck, but if you can sell, you will automatically be successful. If you want to start making money fast, you have to focus solely on the actions that get you paid. Therefore, the fourth pillar of wealth, understand people and focus solely on what gets you paid. The last pillar will explain to you how to trigger a high level of obsession, because you absolutely have to be obsessed with making money if you ever want to become rich. Don't you think it's weird that people can play video games for thousands of hours on end and get extremely, extremely good at a particular video game? If you can trigger this kind of obsession with making money, you would have no trouble getting rich at all. And I'm going to tell you how you can trigger this. Ready? Here it is. Being in a community of like-minded people with the same goal will trigger an obsession to work hard, succeed, and compete. In a friendly way, usually. I played a lot of video games back in the day, and I would literally hate it if my friends were better than me. And I would do everything in my power to become twice as good as they were, and I always succeeded. Humans are like pack animals, and every single person wants recognition from their pack. When you find a group you want to be in, you also start acting like them, so you can blend in and feel like you are part of the group. Do you know the expression, you are what you eat? Well, in this case, it is you are who you hang out with. If you spend most of your time with super competitive people who want to become rich, you are going to develop a strong urge to do the same. Join Facebook groups with entrepreneurs and reach out to people who have the same urge as you to become successful and rich. Therefore, the fifth and last pillar of wealth is find competitive friends and suitable mentors. To summarize, reject getting rich slow and separate time from money. Become better than everyone else by accepting an abundance mindset. Forget what if and focus on what is. Understand people and focus solely on what gets you paid. And find competitive friends and suitable mentors. Thank you for watching, and as always, keep reading as much as you can.